Hello guys, welcome to this video. In this video I'm going to show you how to make a table of content. So for making the table of content, let me quickly add some text into this empty Word document. We'll add text by using the rand command. It will randomly add text in this empty blank document. Okay, so this I have added random text randomly. Now quickly go and add my headings that I want to have it in my table of content. So this is heading 1, introduction. This is of level 1 heading. Okay, this is heading. This is again of level 1, introduction level 1. Put heading here. This is again level 1 heading. Okay, just bear with me for 1 minute. Okay, this is level 1. Why I'm doing level 1, level 2, you will quickly come to know. This is level 2. Okay, and I will add few more, 2 or 3 more. This is level 3 and this is level 4. Level 3. Okay, that's enough. Now to add an table of content, you just have to do assign this thing to a styles. Now suppose if you want to have this thing introduction as a level is your level 1 heading, so just go and click heading 1. Now don't worry about changing format of this text. You can anytime go and modify this thing. And let us say I want this text in black color and its font size should be 14 and it should be a Times New Roman. And okay, this is like this, and there are tons of formatting that you can do. In paragraph, you can see you can indent it on the left side for first characters, second character, spacing, add space before and after paragraph, borders. One thing that I like is borders. I like to have this kind of borders for level 1. Okay, so this is level 1 heading. Now I have modified it. For level 1 heading, again you just have to go and click on level 1 heading and format it as you like it. Okay, this is again a level 1 heading. Okay, this is a level 2 heading. I'll go and click on heading 2. Again, you can go and modify it. I will just quickly modify it to black color and size to 14 and it's 2 times New Roman. Okay, you have other settings like it should be left aligned, right aligned and all these things. Okay, this is heading 2 and this is heading 3, right? Again, I'll just quickly modify it, black color. Okay, I'll keep it Times New Roman. Okay, this is again a heading level 3, and that's all I think. Now once I've finished assigning all the headings to styles, which is of from heading 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, I am done with all the things that is required for making a table of content. Now after that, you just have to go to a place where you want to insert table of content, and I generally prefer to put it in the before the text, and which is generally most of the people think like. Okay, and I've just entered a page break, you can see it here. Yeah, now here I want to add a table of content. For adding table of content, you just have to go to a reference tab and then click on table of content. Okay, there are few styles that are available for you. You can select any one of them and then you can even customize it. Okay, okay, now there are a lot of customization options available here. Now say these are the styles that are available. Okay, these 3 styles, and there are other styles also available. So how do I customize table of content? I just go in reference tab and then click on table of content and then custom table for table of content. Now here there are various options that are available. Now you can see that I have level 1, level 2 and level 3 headings appearing in my table of content. I can say that I want headings only up to level 2. I don't want level 3 headings. So you just go and click show levels 2, and if whenever I press OK, level 3 heading will not be appearing in table of contents. So this is how I do it, and it will ask whether I want to replace table of content. I'll say yes, and see level 3 heading is not appearing in my table. Don't worry if you want to add it again, you just have to go to custom tables and then select level 3. If you want to add heading up to level 4, level 5, you can just go and select these things. Okay, so I in my table I have only a heading up to level 3. So this is how it is appearing, right? So if they were having if they were inside my document, they would have appeared. Now this was one thing. Second thing is I can select whether I want to show page number, right? So if I remove this and press OK, you just see what is happening. This page number will be removed. Okay, so yes, this is how I can add or remove page numbers. Now one more thing that is very useful is if I want to include page number. Okay, yeah, the page number, this dots are called as tab leaders. Now it is always better to have a tab leader, because I don't know when the page number is on the right side and text is on the left side, it sometimes is difficult to associate which page number is for which text, right? So the tab leader is a good option. You have an option of having a tab leader as dot, dash, and the third one also is dash. So you can have different tab leaders. Okay, so I prefer to have a dotted page leader, right? Okay, this is how. And there are a few more options that you have in table of content. See, this is how the table of content will look like. I'll just reduce the number of levels. Okay, so this is a default table. If you this is a classic table of content, then this is a distinct view table of content. Then if you want to have a fancy table of content, this is fancy. Then this is modern, this is formal, and this is simple. Okay, you can select any one of this depending on what you want. And if you want to have a hyperlinking instead of page number, you can click on this hyperlink. So this will be hyperlinked. Suppose if I want to go on heading this text, I just have to press Control and then click it. Here it is showing. Press Control click to follow this link. So this text is hyperlinked. So if when I press heading 2, it is going to this the relevant heading, right? So that's all about how to insert a table of content in Microsoft Word. So thank you for watching this video, and if you have any comments, any suggestion or anything that you want to share with me, you just can comment it. I will appreciate whether it's bad or good, or any good feedback or bad feedback. I request you to please comment it. If you want to see more such videos like this, and you can suggest me some topics, I will try to make a video on that topic. If you don't want to miss any of my videos, please subscribe to my channel and press the bell notification icon there. So that's all from my side. Thank you. Bye-bye.